What's up, guys? I Crow with Spilt Milk here. I'm going to do a different video today. Some of you may know, I'm a big fan of the Now That's What I Call Music series. So a few days ago, I picked up recently released Now 6 and Now 106. Now 6 was originally released in 1985, I believe. There you go, Now 6 and Now 106. There we go. So it's been a current trend that the people who make Now That's What I Call Music, I think it's Sony Music who own it now. It used to be so many other companies, but Sony Music have the right now. They're re-releasing all the older Nows on CD, as you saw Now 6 there. So the question is, for some of you may know, the Now series wasn't originally released on CD. It was only not until Now 10, which I have here, from 1987, I believe. Got hits on there like Barcelona by Freddie Mercury and Monster at Cabaret. Probably can't totally murdering that name. But Rent My Pet Shop Boys, that's another good song. Never Can Say Goodbye by the Communards. Pump Up the Volume, Pump Up the Volume, Pump Up the Volume. Dance by Mars. You also got on disc 2, you've also got La Bamba by Los Lobos, if you remember that tune. I loved Crockett's Theme by Jan Hammer. I use it in quite a lot of my videos, as some of you may know. You also finish off with The Fairy Tale of New York by The Pogues. So, something for everyone on Now 10. That's actually quite a good compilation, I will say. So I've basically done a bit of digging here, and I thought to myself, could have now That's What I Call Music. And what I have here is, this is Now 1 on CD. This is the 25th anniversary edition. It was released in 2008. The Now That's What I Call Music, this was originally released on vinyl and cassette in 1983. So you can see the inside there and other stuff. The CDs come in the sleeves, just like I won't do that much, but yeah, they come as if the vinyls did. So knowing that Now That's What I Call Music 1 or Now 1, but as it's at the time it was Now That's What I Call Music. They didn't know they're going to spawn into a huge compilation series that outlived all the others and stood the test of time. So at the time, Now 1 was released on vinyl and audio cassette. You know, if you don't know about them, ask your parents or grandparents or what have you. I've got a few notes here about CDs or compact discs, as what they're known. So the first commercial compact disc was produced on the 17th of August 1982. A 1979 recording of Chopin and Waltzes by Claudio Arrau. And the first public demonstration was on Tomorrow's World in the UK in 1981. They played the Living Eyes album by the Bee Gees. And the first CD to be played on BBC Radio was in October 1982. On the Jimmy Mac program. Didn't tell me what album it is. Oh yes, it does. It says it was Love Over Gold by Dire Straits. So it wasn't until like 1982, 1983 that the first commercial CDs were released. Now One originally was released at the end of 1983. I think it was October, November time. So if you're looking back at it, it was the perfect time. If they were going to start on CD, that would be the perfect time to do so. So, the short answer to the question, yes, it could have been released on CD originally first time around. It was originally the compact disc format itself was co-developed by Philips and Sony, and it says released here in 1982, and Now One was released in 1983. So yes, they could have been. Now One could have been released in 1983 on CD in addition to audio cassette and vinyl. Some other facts, though. Now 4 was the first... I say Now 4 was the first Now released on CD. It was only a single CD. It was like a best of at that time. Best of Now. You had songs on there from Now 2, Now 3, and Now 4. So... yeah, it was only released on one disc. There was also, after that on CD, it was Now 8 and Now 9 was also released as a single CD, sort of like the best of Now 8, you know, on both the, you know, on the vinyl and the cassette configuration. You had the best tunes on there onto Now 8 and Now 9, and as I showed you before, Now 10. This is the first sort of analog, and I say analog, sort of like where the track list is pretty much exactly the same. Well, it is exactly the same as what was released on vinyl and cassette. So, a few dates there. 1987 was when Now first probably jumped on there. I think that's the sort of time when, you know, towards the end of the 80s, where people were having had, you know, it became more mainstream to have a CD player at home, or device that could play CDs. So that's when they decided to make that commercial choice to release on CDs. Other notes to talk about formats on the Now series. Now 43 was the first Now to be released on minidisc, and they only lasted in 1999. Now 43 was released, and in 2001 with Now 48, that's when the minidisc ceased. Now that's what I call music, were no longer issued on mini discs. So it does go to show you that the people who made Now, whoever it was at the time, it initially was Virgin and EMI. It was a tie between them two. They came together with all the rights, and, you know, came up with the idea of Now's What I Call Music, a compilation CD. So as I say CD, but it's a compilation album, I should say, is the better term. You did have compilation albums, but they're mostly like covers done by cover artists of the songs, or shortened versions, just to fit them all on the playtime on the compilation album. Yeah, so Now 1 that had it's got 30 great tracks on it, including 11 number ones. I mean, 11 number ones on one album was something completely unheard of at the time. That was huge. Again, there's a lot of cooperation between EMI and Virgin required with all the rights to make it happen. So further notes with the vinyls and the cassettes. Vinyls were ceased on Now 35. That was in 1996, I believe. So that's 1990. So it had a good 13-year run on the vinyls. Again, it's... I think that's that sort of time in the mid 90s when CD was definitely overtaking vinyl as the most format used to, or well, compared to vinyl and cassette. So like vinyl and CD, if you compare them both together, vinyl was on the decline and CD was on the climb. Of course, cassette was the most commonly used format in the 90s. The last cassette was now 63. I haven't been able to verify this. That was in 2005, was the last audio cassette. I think it was in the early 2000s, that's when cassettes started to really slump, and CD was overtaking cassettes as the format of choice that people used to listen to their music on. Interestingly enough, on the Now before it, Now 62, that was the first Now in 2004 where there was a digital download version of the album as well, so you could digitally download it as well in Now 62. And that's one another thing I like about the Nows. They capture the mood of what's the mood, like the format mood, you know, with the times. When Sony took over the Now sort of cool music series a few years ago, I was a bit apprehensive. I thought this is going to be turned into a playlist only thing on digital download. Every 4 months you get a new playlist, so that's the end of CD. But no, I'm really glad that we still got this on CD now, 106 in 2020. You got hits on there by Savage Love by Josh685 and Jason Derulo. Harry Styles is on there with Watermelon Sugar, Break My Heart by Dua Lipa. Also got some songs on there from Ellie Goulding, Haim, Katy Perry, One Republic, and you've even got the song in support of the NHS, You'll Never Walk Alone, on there as well. On the previous now 105, you had Matt Lucas's Thank You Baked Potato on that particular edition as well. So there you have it. So now what? Now that's what I call music, or Now One could have been released on CD initially. So yeah, thank you very much for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.